In this video, we'll cover the different ways of selecting objects in Maya. We'll talk about selecting components in the next video. While selection isn't the most exciting topic in the world, it is something that you do all the time, so hopefully you'll learn a few things here that will make your life easier as you're working in Maya. As with Softimage, Maya offers many ways in which you can select objects. The most basic way is to click the Select Tool icon or press the Q key and then click on an object. You can also drag to create a marquee like the Rectangle Select Tool in Softimage, and anything it touches is selected. If you want to move the marquee area without redrawing it, press the Alt key while you drag it to a new position. You can also use the Lasso Tool to drag around objects when a rectangle isn't the best shape to use. Anything that the lasso touches is selected. With either of these tools, you can press Shift to add objects to the selection. But the Shift key in Maya also toggles selection in this case. If you don't want to accidentally deselect objects while you're adding to the selection, press Ctrl plus Shift and then click or drag, which acts like the Shift key in Softimage. To remove objects from the selection, press the Ctrl key as you click or drag over them. The Ctrl key only removes objects from the selection. It doesn't toggle as it does in Softimage. But you can press the Tab key to toggle the selection. To invert the selection of objects, choose Edit Invert Selection or press Ctrl plus Shift plus I. And to isolate selected objects, click the Isolate Selected icon in a viewport or press Shift plus I. If you want to select all selectable objects in the scene, choose Edit Select All or press Ctrl plus Shift plus A. Choose Deselect All or click and drag in an empty area of your scene to deselect all objects. Note that there's no hotkey for this command, so you may want to create one to make life easier. You can also choose an option from the Edit Select All by Type menu to select all objects of only that type. For example, you can select just the NURBS surfaces or just NURBS curves in a scene. When you select multiple objects, you may notice that the last one selected, known as the key or lead object, is always green, while the others are white. Maya does this to let you know the order of selection, which it uses for certain operations, the same as you have with picking sessions in Softimage. For example, when you select objects to create a hierarchy, the green object will be the parent. Or when you're creating constraints, the green object will be the one that is constrained. You can change this color in the Color Settings window. Click the Active tab and customize the lead object color. If you like, you can even turn off the selection highlighting completely in a viewport by selecting this option in the Show menu. The selection mode icons in the status line are similar to the select modes in Softimage. The Select by Object Type mode, known as Object Mode, is on by default. With this mode on, you can click the Object Type filters to decide exactly what you can or can't select with the Select tools, such as joints, curves, surfaces, deformation objects, or dynamics objects. Right-click on an icon to get more specific on each filter's selections, such as not being able to select NURBS surfaces. The Select by Component mode lets you select only components on an object, such as faces, vertices, and edges, which we'll cover in the next video. To toggle between the object and component modes, you can press the F8 key. Let's move on to selecting objects in hierarchies. You'll find that this is an area that will take a bit of getting used to, coming from Softimage. In Maya, a parent object's transform node is the topmost node in a hierarchy. You can left-click a child object to node select, the same as in Softimage. And when you left-click a parent object to node select it, you're selecting only its transform node. You'll notice that the children are highlighted in the viewport, but they're not actually selected, as you can see in the outliner. In Maya, there is no such thing as middle-clicking a parent object to branch select its children. However, the parent's transform node controls the transformations of the parent and children as a unit without needing to select the children. This is the same as what transforming a parent object does by default in Softimage. If you like, you can set a preference to disable the highlighting of the children when you select the parent. Click Selection and choose Never Highlight from the Selection Child highlighting list. To navigate in a hierarchy, you can use the arrow keys. Press the right arrow key to select the next sibling of the selected object, the left arrow key to select the previous sibling, the up arrow key to select the parent's transform node, and the down arrow to select the parent's shape node. The Select by Hierarchy root mode allows you to select the top-level node of hierarchies or groups when you select any object in that hierarchy or group. This is a bit like tree selection in Softimage when you right-click on any object in a hierarchy to select the whole tree. This makes it easy to delete the whole hierarchy with just having the topmost parent selected. If you want to select all objects in a hierarchy, choose Edit Select Hierarchy, or right-click the parent object and choose Select Hierarchy. But be aware that this is not like tree selection in Softimage, but more like the Select Child Nodes command, where each object in the hierarchy is node selected. In addition to hierarchies of geometric objects, you can create groups in Maya. Groups in Maya are totally different from what groups are in Softimage, and are actually closer to what transform groups are in Softimage. All group members are like children under an empty transform node, sort of like a null parent object, that controls the transformations of the group as a unit. We'll get into creating hierarchies and groups in another video, but for more information, you can watch the video Parenting and Grouping Objects on the Maya Learning Channel. In addition to working with hierarchies, you'll find the outliner a useful tool for selecting any object in the scene, especially hidden ones. You can multi-select by pressing Shift while you click or drag to select a range of nodes. And use the Control key to toggle the selection. As in Softimage, you can select objects by name in Maya. In the selection box in the outliner, you can type a name, including wildcards, to find and select any nodes with that string in them. Be aware that the search is context sensitive, so if you enter gas with a capital G, you'll get different results. Sometimes in multi-level hierarchies or groups, it's difficult to find individual nodes that are hidden deep in the structure. To make this easier, select the objects in the viewport and then press the F key in the outliner, the same way as you do to find nodes in the Explorer in Softimage. You can also choose Display Reveal Selected to do the same thing. Finding nodes this way automatically expands the node structure so that you can see the selected node. Of course, you can expand and collapse node hierarchies using the plus and minus icons as usual. You can also press Shift and click these icons to expand and collapse all nodes in the hierarchy at once, which is a big time saver. If you have a lot of nodes in the outliner, there are a few ways in which you can manage their display. You can drag the splitter at the bottom of the outliner to divide it into two sections. This way, you don't need to scroll as much from the top to the bottom. You can also hide specific nodes in the outliner by selecting them and choosing Display, Hide an Outliner, Hide. To show the nodes again, you can choose Unhide, but the nodes need to be selected for this to work, which won't be the case if you have meanwhile selected something else. If this is the case, you can select Ignore Hidden in Outliner to see all hidden nodes in the outliner again. And then if you want, you can select these nodes and choose Unhide so that they're not flagged as hidden anymore. In the Show Objects menu, you can filter the object types you want to see in the outliner for a less cluttered view. For example, you can filter to see only nodes that have polygons, then add other object types too. Choose Clear Below from this menu to remove all filters. You can also choose to display attributes in the outliner, and then filter them in the Show Attributes menu, as you do with object types. One last thing we'll look at is display layers, which provide a way to determine the selectability of objects. As described in the video on this channel, showing and hiding objects in Maya, you can make objects unselectable by templating or referencing their layer. These background type layers in our scene have been referenced so that they look normal, but the objects can't be selected. If layers are normal, you can select all objects in that layer by choosing Layers, Select Object in Selected Layers, or select a single layer, then right-click on it and choose Select Objects. So that pretty much covers the main stuff about selecting objects in Maya. In the next video, we'll go over how to select components.